I'm happy to announce, and we announced early this morning, around I think it was around 1 a.m., that the boil water notice that had been in effect for those served by the Highland Park Reservoir has been lifted. Water quality tests ordered by Monroe County Department of Environmental Health have confirmed the safety of the water supply. And I remind folks that we did this as a added level of caution. All the city's tests, we test the water regularly, have shown that it was safe, but we had to have this extra added layer of protection out of an abundance of caution, as we said earlier. Our own data collected in the weeks and months prior to that mirrored those findings, and as I've always touted, the quality of our water wins awards regularly, so our water was never in question, but it was important to have this extra layer of protection. City Hall was also affected by the reservoir. We are served by that reservoir for water. I drank some of the water this morning here at City Hall. We regularly conduct E. coli and coliform at Highland Reservoir at least 5 times a week. In addition to those tests, the water system is set up to test and document many different water quality parameters in real time every 15 seconds. So we regularly test this water to ensure that it is safe. And none of the data that we collected over the past few months has indicated any issues in our water supply. And this is important to keep in mind because over the last day, we have confirmed the identity of the victim and have confirmed when he fell into the reservoir. The medical examiner has confirmed the man to be 29-year-old Abduli Muya. The preliminary investigation has found that Mr. Muya entered the gated reservoir area during the early mornings of February 24th. A short while later, at approximately 6:30 a.m., he slid down the side of the reservoir into the water and tragically died. There was no one else present, and it does not appear that there is any criminal element to this investigation. Our heartfelt condolences go out to the Muya family, who have been diligently searching for him since they reported him missing. Some of you have covered this story about his family looking for him. This obviously calls into question, how could he have not been detected in the reservoir being there that long? And this is a question that all of us are asking, me in particular. The reservoir is fenced, as you know, it has spikes, but that does not deter someone who may be determined to get in. There's also cameras around the perimeter, some with heat and motion sensors. The Bureau is patrolled regularly by city security and Water Bureau personnel. In addition, high-tech and real-time monitoring of the water measures turbidity, conductivity, and other factors. In fact, I mean, this area is so sensitive that it can even alert us if a windstorm is coming. And yet, we did not know that Mr. Muir had gotten into the area or that he had entered the water. At around 8 a.m. on March 18th, during their daily rounds, City Water Bureau staff saw Mr. Muir below the surface. He was up against the inlet structure in the shadows of the north side of the reservoir, which one could draw from that they did not see him the entire time that he was there. This reservoir is extremely deep, 15 feet deep, and the body was well below the surface. Reflection waves and shadows at the specific location can obscure the view of the bottom. Obviously, this is very traumatic for the Water Bureau team, and they're saddened by the circumstances and wish it would have been a different outcome. I will tell you that we are working now to determine how we can address any gaps in security to ensure no physical breaches of the perimeter happen in the future. I'm very concerned that someone was able to breach that water system. As it relates to the safety of our water, our diligent and continuous testing identifies no immediate concern. So while I'm not concerned about the water quality, we test that regularly. We get our water from, as you know, lakes, and stuff gets into the water, but we filter it out because of our water quality folks. So while we maintain our standard operating procedures as it relates to water quality, we are going to look into the security around our reservoir. For now, the Water Bureau is beginning to empty out the reservoir, and the cleaning process will continue for several weeks. But as I mentioned at the outset, the boil water advisory is lifted. We will continue to boil our water, and we are happy that our quality of water is still at the highest level that it's been. And again, our condolences go out to the Muya family. Obviously, there's still some investigatory steps that need to take place. We probably won't be able to answer anything related specifically to Mr. Muya and how he got there, because we still have to figure a lot of that out. But I will take any questions that we can answer here, and if I can't answer them, I have the commissioner and the chief that can weigh in. So, questions? Yes. Well, I mean, it should not take that long, because we were able to backtrack and look at footage. I think that the bigger thing is how do we prevent something like this from happening again? No one should be able to get into a reservoir. I mean, those stakes are extremely high. There's, you know, there's cameras everywhere. That's what we have to get to the bottom of. It's how someone can breach that and not be alerted immediately that someone has gone over a fence to get into a water supply area. We'd have to get you answers to that question. I would say, obviously, at the time that he went into the water, there must not have been anybody reviewing it. Because if there was, they would have saw him immediately get in there. And, you know, we have cameras all over the city that record regularly. And sometimes you look at footage when, you know, an event happens or something happens. But there was no indication that something was happening. So that footage probably was not looked at that time. But, again, that's something that I will be asking for and looking at. We'll also be talking to all of our partners, security folks, to see exactly is that a best practice that can be looked at, that you can look at camera footage. But remember, this is a 24/7 operation. Any other questions?
Were you guys supposed to have any safety measures covering that reservoir?
Well, great question, and I can have Commissioner Perrin talk to that. No, not yet. So there's a lot of controversy that you may have heard about is it T2? Is that what it's called? LT2, which says that the Highland Reservoir needs to be covered. There are folks that are adamantly opposed to that. The federal government has made clear at some point that reservoir is going to need to be covered. And because we don't cover it, we have to meet extreme strict guidelines in terms of the water quality and the water testing, which has so far showed that even though it has not been covered, the water quality has always been good. I will tell you that this incident does, I believe, bring into stark relief the necessity or conversation about covering that reservoir. And I know that there are some people who are adamantly opposed to it. They love the beauty and majesty of being able to walk and run around the reservoir. But unfortunately, this conversation is going to have to resurface probably very soon in terms of the covering. I believe we had until when?
But
we'll see if we end up having to cover it or not covering it. But as long as we are in compliance with state and federal guidelines, and we are, in terms of keeping the water safe, it's open for now. Any other questions? Yeah. We're still getting into that. Do you have the specifics? He climbed over. He was able to climb over the fence, which is an amazing feat, being that this is a spike there. Yeah, but to answer your question, he climbed over the fence. Any other questions? Go ahead. It started. It's already started. At least 8 weeks. And then we'll clean it. Now, this was already scheduled anyway. We do this regularly, but we're accelerating the calendar. We were supposed to do this in, was it May? We were supposed to do it in May, but now we moved it up, and we're going to do it in March. Any other? Yes, last question. Yeah, I'm not sure about all that yet, but we just know that he was able to get over that fence and get in the water. And to Ericetta? To Ericetta's point, I mean, the way it's set up, it's difficult. It is difficult to get over one of those fences. Any kid that knows, you know, back in the day, you'd run and you jump fences. I mean, this is not a fence that you can jump. And that's why, and so my concern right now is not our water quality. We treat water, it's good, right? We have great water. In Rochester, we invest so much in infrastructure as it relates to water. Thank God we do. And all of our tests over the last years have shown that there's no issues with our water. My concern, and the team knows, that what I'm not happy about, and I'll be very clear about that, is how this individual was, how we had a breach in security. But even more sad is that a person lost their life, and my heart goes out to their family. But from a security standpoint, you can be darn sure that I, in particular, more so than anybody else, is going to be asking a lot of questions about how someone was able to breach one of our water facilities. That's concerning for me, and I think the team knows that, and we will get to the bottom of that and make sure that we let the community know what our plan is to make sure that we don't have breaches at any of our water facilities. Thank you very much, everybody.